Hello students, today we will take revision of properties of natural resources, and for that revision I gave you open book tester on Saturday, and today we are going to discuss on this lesson. Okay, so first of all, the first question is the define or explain the following terms. So define means you have to write the definition, otherwise we have to write the explanation related to that term. So for this question, first it is the atmospheric pressure I gave you, then scattering of light, anomalous behavior of water, and the density of water. And to find these answers on page number 16-2, means 16 onwards, you have to find out these answers. So first of all, we will see the atmospheric pressure. So you just all of you open the page number 16. So here it is, the lesson number 3, properties of natural resources. And define inside, I first of all ask you the atmospheric pressures definition. So as you move the downside, here you will see the atmospheric pressure. Okay, so what is atmospheric pressure? So the molecules of the gases in the air are in constant motion. Okay, so these gases are there, they are constantly, randomly, they are moving in the different directions. When these molecules strike on a body, so these molecules when strike on our body, they create a pressure on that body, and this pressure of the air, that we called as a atmospheric pressure. So this is the definition of atmospheric pressure. Next, it is the second definition is the scattering of the light. So what is the scattering of the light? So to understand it, we will move towards the next page number 18. If you see here it is the scattering of light. So what is the scattering of light? As we all know that when the rays of light falls on the minute particles, otherwise you just start this definition from air only. Air is a mixture of very tiny fine particles of some gases, dust, smoke, and moisture. When rays of light falls on these minute particles, the particles spread the light in all direction, and this natural phenomenon is called as a scattering of the light. This is the definition of the scattering of light. For the next definition, we will move towards the third definition, anomalous behavior of water. So What is anomalous behavior of water? Actually, this is the explain the term inside this question will come. Okay, so here for this explain term inside, what we have to write? How to write the anomalous behavior of water? So we have to start from here. The density of water is peculiar when water at normal temperature start cooling. Its density increases. Its density increases like that most liquids. However, if its temperature falls below 0 degree Celsius, its density start decreasing. Means water density decreases below 4 degree Celsius. This means that the density of water is maximum at 4 degree Celsius. And if the temperature of water lowered below 4 degree Celsius, means temperature decreases minus 4 degree Celsius, then what happens? Its density decreases and volume increases. This thing is happening. It means that the water expand. It wants more space when the temperature falls 4 degree Celsius. And this behavior of the water is called as an anomalous behavior of the water. Understood all of you? So this paragraph is acceptable for this term, that is the anomalous behavior of the water. The next fourth definition is the density of water. So the density of water is here, it is the density of waters. So what is density of water? The interrelation b- between the volume and mass of the substance is called as its density. And density means what? Mass upon volume. Explain the term, it is there. That's why you have to write this, all things inside it. This is the interrelation between the volume and mass of the substance. Space occupied by the substance is its volume. The store of matter substance is of its mass. And what is density? Density is equals to mass upon volume. If your definition is there, then write density is equal to mass upon volume. And volume, mass is measured in the density. Mass is measured in gram, and volume we are measuring the cubic centimeter. So the unit of density is the gram per cc, means gram per cubic centimeter. If the mass of 1 liter of water is 1 kg, then it, what is the density? This is the question, and that question I think you have to do the find this question's answer. Okay, tomorrow we will discuss on this question. Already when I all of you just see the lecture that I have taken on this lesson, okay, till they are on the that links is are available on YouTube, and if you see this question I had explained you in that video. Okay, now the next question is the give reason. So what is the give reasons question? We hear the whistle of the distant train clearly early in the morning in the winter. This is the question, give reason statement is there. We can hear the whistle of distant train clearly in early in the morning of winter, but not in summer. This is the question. So for this question, we will move towards the textbook. So answer of this question will come under the heading of transmission of sound, and it is on page number 19. Okay, so here it is page number 19, and here it is the transmission of sound. So if you see here, you will notice that all the sound that we hear reach us through a surrounding air. The density of air also changes due to change in temperature. So here it is given. So that is the here what they told you. All the sound we hear reach through the surrounding air. The density of air also changes. Changes due to change in temperature. So as the temperature changes, the density is also changes. So what happens in winter? The temperature is low. So in winter, the density of air increases. The temperature is low, so the density is increases, and we can hear the whistle of distinct train clearly early in the morning in the winter, because air is air is a useful medium for the transmission of sound. So for this give reason, this property you have to write. Okay, this is the second this point inside if you want to write. So you have to write this first one, this is second one. Okay, and here the third point is this, and so we can hear the density of the hear the whistle of a train clearly in the morning of winter. We will get this answer. Okay, now the give reason inside second question I gave you, what? Air is a homogeneous mixture of various gases. Okay, so for that, and that question I ask you from the exercise. Okay, and for that question you have to write your own opinion. Okay, so here it is the question, page number 25. See, air is a homogeneous mixture of various gases. So as we know that air is consist of different gases like CO2, oxygen, then afterwards CO, nitrogen. So, and with this water vapors are present, water vapors are present in the air. With water vapors, some dust particles are also present in the air. But these all particles we cannot, means they are homogeneous, they are equal. We cannot identify that this is carbon dioxide. First of all, air we can't see only. So here this air is a mixture. So this is a homogeneous mixture. The meaning of it is that it is, we cannot separate these things. So it is called as air is a homogeneous mixture of different gases. Okay, next question of the give reason is the in summer wet clothes dry quickly than rainy season. In summer the wet clothes dry quickly than in rainy season. Its answer you can write in your own words also. As we know that the summer season the temperature is more, so the water vapors are content of water vapor in the air is less than that of the in the rainy season. In rainy season, there is a more water water vapors are present in the air, and due to this, what happens? The air inside water moisture is more, so the from the clothes the air water drops, water cannot be absorbed, so the wet clothes are dry quickly in summer season, not in rainy season. This we knows only, but we have to find this answer, and its answer is on page number 18 of our textbook. We will see now. So here it is, page number 18, and if you see here, if you read this book, then you know that the question is here. Here it is, that question, that the clothes dry quickly in summer, but in rainy season they do not. And the reason behind it is that this, the proportion of water vapor in the air is high during monsoon, and in coastal region, as a result, we feel dampness or humidity. And humidity is more, there is a, what happens? The water from the clothes not get absorb in the air, and due to this, what happens? The clothes are in rainy season, what dries, what slowly, okay, than that of the in summer season. After this question, the question number 3 that I ask you from the that we have to write the properties of water, okay. So here it is the question, properties of water insides. So that properties of water we have to find here, and next question is the write the short note on temperature regulation, that we will see in the textbook. So if you see this picture, you will get the idea about the properties of water, and here it is given only. Water occurs, so here are the properties of the water. Water occurs in liquid state at ordinary temperature, okay. Water is a fluid substance. Water does not have its own shape, but it has a volume. It can pass through small hole and seeps through very small gaps or the cracks, okay. And then next, next properties are there with this. Water is a universal solvent, as we know that this property also you can add this with this. And water is a water shows anomalous behavior, means it shows on freezing it turns into the solid, okay, and till 4 degrees Celsius, that anomalous behavior inside we seen that. If you add this point also in this, then also, okay, if the temperature of water lower below 4 degrees Celsius, its density decreases and volume increases, okay. This point if you are add in this question, then also, okay. Now next point is the temperature regulation short note I told you to write in this. So for this we have to move towards the 19 page number. So here it is the paragraph which shows the temperature regulation, and points from this only paragraph we have to write for this question. So what is temperature regulation? As we know that the earth receives energy from the sun, and this energy is reflected by the earth in the form of heat. The constituent of air surrounding the earth, such as water vapor, carbon dioxide, absorb the part of this heat and give it to the other constituents of the air. As a result, the earth's surface remains warm and thereby becomes suitable for the living world of the earth, okay. And if there were no air with the earth, the average temperature of the earth surface would have been very low, and that is that these points we have to, and because of this temperature regulation of this constituents like water vapor, carbon dioxide, the living things are exist on the earth, and for this we have to write this paragraph for this question. And the last question that I ask you in the test is the write why ice floats on the surface of the water. Why ice floats on the surface of the water, and to see the answer of this question. So the points we had studied in this picture only, if you see, the here it is the water, and here it is the ice cubes, and you see here in the picture ice cubes are floating on the surface of the water, and you have experienced it whenever you are taking the cold drinks, otherwise any juice. By adding that ice cubes inside it, you will notice that the ice cubes are floating on the surface of this water. And why this is happening? The reason behind it is that only one, it's a density. Okay, so here is the reason of it. Why ice is lighter than water? When water freezes to form a ice, it becomes lighter than the original liquid. Okay, means its density decreases. When water freezes, that is when it transforms into solid state, its volume increases, and that's why, therefore, the density of ice is less than that of the water, and that is why the ice float on the surface of the water is the answer for the question number 5. And all these answers you will get it when you will read the lesson carefully. You will underline the main points from the textbook, then you will get easily answers for this question. So today we have finished the page number 16 to 20 page number from our textbook, and the remaining lessons revision we will take tomorrow. Okay, and then the one more lesson is left after tomorrow, nutrition in living organism. This test, whole lessons test, I am going to give in one lecture only. Okay, because we have to finish our revision before the exam. So today we will stop here only, and all of you remaining lesson and fourth lesson also, all of you read it and then underline the main points, find the answer, prepare your own questions answer, you find it, and then you will be solve the test very easily. Okay, so today we will stop here only. Okay, thank you and have a good day.